I feel great honor to be here. On behalf of Professor Lin Jian, the director of our museum, I will introduce a project entitled The Bridge Between Heritage and Public here. So let's see where is Changzhou first. Changzhou is a medium-sized city in the eastern China. The green area is Jiangsu province, and the yellow one is Changzhou. It is located on the southern bank of Yangtze River and on the west of Shanghai. The population of Changzhou is about 4,070,000. And Changzhou is an ancient city with a history of about 2,500 years. And is also known as the famous historical city. By far, Changzhou has got one World Cultural Heritage and 13 National Intangible Cultural Heritages. At the Neolithic age of about 6,000 years ago, the ancestors of Changzhou had created splendid and superb ancient culture. The picture here shows the archaeological excavation of Weidong ruins and the reconstruction scene and some of its cultural relics. The ruins of Yancheng comprise the remains of a walled city and was founded over 3,000 years ago. Yancheng is consisted of three walls, you can see three walls and three moats, and the outmost of the city is about 2,500 meters in girth. The Grand Canal was excavated at about 2,500 years ago and was listed as the World Cultural Heritage in 2014. The Grand Canal of Changzhou section traverses the whole city and is about 46 kilometers long. So, after introducing about the Changzhou city, I will talk about our project next. It can be divided into four parts. The first is Changzhou Museum, second exhibition, the third heritage utilization, and the last is social engagement. I will talk about appearance, history, staff, audience, and collection of Changzhou Museum. And all of these above are the basis to let our museum to play a better role as the bridge between heritage and public. Changzhou Museum is a small-sized but comprehensive museum with a combination of human history, natural history, and art. And the reconstruction of our museum is about 28 square meters. Changzhou Museum was founded in 1958 in a small pavilion called Hongmei, which means the red plume, and has relocated for three times. In 2007, our new museum was opened. And we have only 46 permanent staff and 30 temporary ones. Under director, there are 10 departments. That is office, collection, exhibition, education, archaeology, nature, networks, security, academy, and relics protection department. And this graph, we did a statistic for the numbers of the audience who visit our museum and the audience who visit our exhibitions in other museums. In 2014, there are about 848,800 audience in total, and the number dropped a bit in 2015, but increased to 1,069,200 in 2016. And there are over 30,000 pieces of collections in our museum, include the humanity historical collection and the natural historical collection. The ratio of these two types is about 3-to-1. And among the humanity historical collections, The most representatives include the jade and the porcelain and the pottery bricks and the lacquer and the porcelain and the paintings. Here are some examples. The jade tomb is a special invention by Liangzhu people for about 4,500 years ago. It is a cylindrical jade with a circular inner and a square outer, and it is acted as one of the oldest traditional ritual vessels. And the pottery bricks are about 1,500 years old, and it is used for decorating the tops. We have many types of pottery bricks in our collection, such as the maid and warrior images, and excellent masterpieces with exquisite craft and elegant shape. The laccaware are nearly 1,000 years old, and it is one of the earliest laccaware which incised and filled with gold dust, and are well preserved with inscription. It can be divided into three layers, and the cover on the top depicts several ladies taking a summer holiday. We have got more than 8,000 pieces of natural historical collections in our museum, include animals, plants, fossils, minerals, and rocks. And we have already formed 6 series of collections, including land fur animals, the marine animals, the wild insects, the local herbs, the mineral crystals, and precious fossils. As my major is paleontologist, so I will show you some excellent fossils. It is a kind of dinosaur called Pachycosaurus, which is about 120 million years ago from northeastern China. The whole skeleton is nearly completed, which is very precious. This is another kind of dinosaur called Anchiornis. The unique feature lies on its feather. It is one of the earliest feathered dinosaurs so far, which is about 2 million years earlier than the famous Archaeopteryx from Germany. And it is a kind of bird fossil, which is the offspring of the feathered dinosaurs. I don't know, maybe you know, the bird is evolved from the dinosaurs. You know? No? Yes, yes. Dinosaurs are not extinct. They are flying into the sky. The black imprint is the trace of its feather, and it is a very beautiful bird with 2 long tail feathers. The second part is exhibition. Exhibition is the first and important bridge between heritage and public. We have 2 basic kinds of exhibition, the permanent and temporary. And the temporary exhibition can be also divided into 2 types, the exhibitions inside our museum and exhibitions brought out to other museums. We have 4 permanent exhibitions, which is about 4,000 square meters. The first is the Changzhou History and Culture Display, which exhibits the rich local culture deposits. The second one is the Natural Resources Display, which is the most favorite exhibition, especially for the children. The third one is Xiezhiliu Art Work Display, which shows the artistic career and brilliant achievements of Mr. Xie. The last one is Hongmu Furniture Display donated by Mr. Liu Guojun, which reappears the civilian residence and the life scenes of the Southern Yangtze River. And we often hold about a dozen of temporary exhibitions every year. And this graph shows you the temporary exhibitions during the past 3 years. The darker columns represent exhibitions inside our museum, and the lighter ones represent exhibitions brought out to other museums. And this map shows you the temporary exhibitions inside our museum. We often introduced dozens of excellent exhibitions in, which covers many cities of about 16 provinces. I used the pink color from all over China. And we also brought two exhibitions from USA and Australia. Here are some representatives. The Dunhuang Art Exhibition was introduced from Dunhuang Academy in 2015. I don't know if you know about Dunhuang. The Mogao Cave, also known as the Thousand Buddha Grottoes, is about 2,500 kilometers from Changzhou. The distance is about twice as far away from Dubrovnik Hill to Paris. Yeah. And the Dunhuang Cave has been approved as the World Cultural Heritage in 1987. So the exhibition brings the art of Dunhuang to Changzhou people, which covers many aspects such as sculpture, architecture, calligraphy, embroidery, literature, music, dance, etc. And this exhibition also attracted about 300,000 audiences into our museum. We also brought foreign cultural exhibitions in, such as the DNA Bloodlines and the Family of Mankind. It is designed by Tony Scott, who has descent of Native American, African, and European. This exhibition provides informative and interactive messages and provides the cross-cultural exchange and friendly communications. And look, there are many people who listen to Tony Scott. This is the original exhibition designed by us this year. As you know, fossils are the precious natural heritages of the world from millions of years ago. So we use more than 100 pieces of fossils to introduce the evolutionary history of the Earth and the life on it. Look at the picture. The children are very seriously and excited to imagine and draw the ancient animals on paper. This map shows you the temporary exhibitions which were brought out to other museums, which covers many cities from about 9 provinces of China. And these kinds of exhibitions have made a good effect, especially the original natural exhibitions, which received a warm welcome from the audience all over our country. Here are some examples. The exhibition of calligraphy and paintings of Changzhou had been to Pori Art Museum of Beijing in 2014. This exhibition led the Changzhou Painting School showing in front of many more people and promote the cultural communication between Changzhou and Beijing and acted as the good bridge between heritage and public. The exhibition of butterfly and their cultural crafts combines the natural resources with the Chinese traditional culture to let the people cherish our nature and cherish our cultural heritage. This exhibition had been to about 10 cities of 5 provinces in China. And this exhibition is the birds and flower and bird paintings, which put the bird specimens and paintings together to popularize the scientific and cultural knowledge. Not only our modern people love nature, the ancient people also did. So they put the beautiful animals and plants into their paintings. so that we can see all those beauties hundreds of years later. This exhibition had been to three cities during the past years. And the third part is heritage utilization. As I have mentioned, we have so many beautiful and precious cultural heritage and natural heritage in the world. And not all of us can go and see them by ourselves. As some are very far away from our homes, and some are real in our daily life. So the heritage utilization is very important for us to play the part as the bridge between heritage and public. Here is an example. The Dunhuang on the fingertips is a series of educational activities between the heritage and public. The local culture is deeply rooted in a particular human and natural environment, but now it is losing rapidly. So the task lies on us to protect and make record of them. So we combine the intangible cultural heritage of Changzhou and with the world cultural heritage of Dunhuang to enlighten the brilliant sparkles. The educational activity of Dunhuang on the fingertips is very successful. We hold about 14 projects, 167 rounds. 300,000 audiences have watched our exhibition, and about 2,670 audiences had taken part in our activities. Here are some examples. The Jintan paper cat is one of the oldest Chinese folk cat, and the Jintan district is one of the oldest popular regions of Chinese paper cat. Along with another three paper cat, Jintan paper cat had been approved as the World Intangible Cultural Heritage in 2009. And the picture shows Mr. Yang created new works of Dunhuang for the students, which is derived from the mural of the cave number 407. And Changzhou cope making is the National Intangible Cultural Heritage, and which can be traced to about 1,600 years ago. And the cope should be gone through 28 procedures before completed. So the picture shows the teachers taught the students how to make a cope on the machine. And the students are very seriously at drawing the images on the copes. And the children's drama of the story of the nine-colored deer is a new attempt in our museum. And the drama can be divided into seven acts, which tells people a story of the chew, the good, and the beauty. And look at the picture. The old lady in the middle is Professor Fan Jingshi. I don't know if anybody know Professor Fan Jingshi. She was the dean of Dunhuang Academy and also known as the daughter of Dunhuang. Perhaps after watching the drama, there is not only a pride on her face, but more a comfort and satisfaction. As I have mentioned, we have a lot of precious and beautiful natural collections in our museum, such as the shells, birds, butterfly, fossils, minerals, and so on. But they are all housed in the warehouse of our museum and had little chance to face the public, except in a few exhibitions. So to the public, the museum and its collections are very mysterious and untouchable. So we choose a new mode of perceptible, tangible, and experiential to bring the collections to the schools and communities and let the students and citizens to touch the specimen and deepen their understanding by their eyes, ears, and hands. The picture here shows you the shell exhibition brought into the schools. You can look at the children's face. They are very, very excited and carefree to touch the shells. And the last part is the social engagement. It is very important for us because we have not enough staffs. So we invite and absorb specialists, volunteers, and social elites to help us to play a better role as the graduating heritage and public. The public lectures are elaborated by us for about 5 years. We wish to break the invisible wall of our museum to let people know more about our museum and approach museum and love museum. And we often hold about 1 to 2 lectures per month. And I believe almost every museum has volunteers. They are very important to us, especially for the audience. So let's take 2014 for example. We have 141 members, serving people 7,760 hours, and made 796 sessions of interpretation for 19,715 audiences. And the volunteers in our museum include the teachers, artists, college students, and foreign friends. They made lectures, gave lessons, put on performance, and made interpretations for the public. And the museum membership is also very important for us, which is consisted of the people who love museum, devoted to cultural fields, and willing to do contributions to our museum. There are three kinds of members in our museum: the ordinary, senior, and group member. This graph shows you the increased number of the members in our museum during the past 3 years. And the members in our museum have taken part in many activities, such as donating personal collections and acting as the volunteers, enjoying the cultural activities. Just because we have done all of these above, the exhibition, educational activity, volunteers, and so on, we have been working hard to play an excellent role as the bridge between heritage and public. So we have honored the Chinese Museum Association's award for the National Most Innovative Museum in 2016. That is why Changzhou Museum could come here and share experience with all of you. Okay, that's all for my presentation. Thank you for your attention. Welcome to Changzhou. Welcome to our museum. Thank you.